Hello friends, in this video we are going to look at object class in Java. So in the previous video series or playlist, we learned about Java language fundamentals. So welcome to this new series. Here we are going to study about Java API. So in this first video, we are going to look at Java object class. Java object is inherited to every class we create. That means it indirectly states that all the classes in Java somehow inherited from object. Either it is directly inherited or it will have object as the supermost class. When we does not extend a class, the object class becomes a super class for it. See, for example, you are defining a class called person, and this person doesn't belongs to any super class, any existing super class. So in that case, Java makes object as the super class for this person. So we can say person now derived from object class. Now let us look at this example. Let us say first we created class A. Since it is not inherited from any other existing class, the object class of Java becomes base class for this class A. So automatically the inheritance relationship exists between object and class A. So object class is the base class and A is the subclass for the object. So this inheritance relationship automatically exists. Next, let us say we are extending class B from class A. So here the user will see A as the base class for B. But if we have a closer look at, since A is already inherited from object, all the methods of object is get inherited to B also. So we can say B is indirectly derived from object because it derived class A. Since class A is derived from object, we can say B also derived from object. So this is how we can see all Java classes are inherited from object class. Here we can say A is inherited from object class. Even though it doesn't specify any inheritance relation, Java will automatically impose that. Then we create class B that extends class A, but still B is derived from object because A is derived from object. So the below list shows the list of methods in object class. The methods are toString equals hashCode notify notify all wait clone and finalize. So the toString will return a string representation of the object. We will see an example for this toString in the coming video series. Next, there is a method called equals. It is useful to compare two objects. The equality operator won't help here, and we will see how equals resolves that issue. So that we will see in some other video. Next, hashCode returns a integer format of a value that represents this object uniquely. I would say almost uniquely, 99.99% we can say. So this hash code is useful when the object contains a collection. So for example, there is a employee class which will have a collection of employees, and the collection may hold, let's assume, 1 lakh to 2 lakh employees. So if you want to compare two such objects, then the comparison requires comparing 2 lakhs of employee. So the hash code provides a way so that we can say two objects are equal by comparing the hash codes. So this makes the life easier. We will learn more about hash code in some other video. So here we are just looking at the object class basics or overview of object. Notify or wait. All these methods are useful for threading. The clone method creates clone of the existing object, or we can say it copies the existing object and returns back. So the returned copy will have the same data member with values. The finalize method is useful for cleaning the object. So for example, if you created a connection to a database, or you connected to a network machine, or you allocated some other objects in the heap. So the finalize method is useful to perform all the cleanup activity. So when we talked about, we told you created some object in heap. So the heap objects will automatically garbage collected, but the finalize method is useful to double check this. Usually finalize method is useful for clearing the resources, like closing the file handle, closing the connection to database, all this stuff. Since object class is inherited to every class, all the above methods are available to all the classes. Here, the listed methods are either public or protected. Let us explore objects in Eclipse. So here is our Eclipse. First, what we will do, as told in the example, first we will create two classes. Before that, we will create a Java project. Since you watched the basic video series, I mean the playlist one on this Java topic, I will be a little faster in creating the project and classes. So if you need, you can pause and look at the video. By this time, I hope you will be convenient in using the Eclipse for creating the project, classes, all the stuff. So here is our project. Next, we will create a class. The class name is E, and nothing else is required. If we need, we can put some members here. Public int ex, and then we will put one more member. So next, we will create one more class. New class, and we will name this as B. And if you see, by default, the ID here shows that the superclass is a JavaLang object. So now I'm going to change this as class A from our default package. Finish. That's all here, and here you can see the inheritance relation. Now what we will do, we will bring up the type hierarchy. So in the type hierarchy, if you see, class P has member M and N, and A has X and Y, and here is the object class members. And if you see, all the method whatever we discussed is available here. We talked about weight. There are three overload version for the weight. We already know about method overloading. It was discussed in the previous video series. Then there is a method called toString, notify all, hash code, get class. I think we doesn't list get class, finalize equals clone. So all these methods are there in Java object class. So if you see, show all inherited members. So once you click that, you can see that all these members are available for class A. Since this is available for class A, when I go to class B, class A members X and Y is available, and M and N, that is defined in class B. After that, here you are still seeing the object class methods. So that's why we can say all the classes in Java, whether we create a standalone class like A, here it doesn't show extends object, but it is actually derived from object. That's the default. When we doesn't inherit a class, then it automatically get inherited from object class. You can see that relation here. Next, class B extends A. Here also we can see object class members get inherited. So that's all in the very first video. Thanks for watching. If you like the channel, subscribe it. Bye.